to mention that Ambassador Thomas Kwesi Kwarteh, the deputy chairperson of the African Union, which is based in the Ethiopian capital Addis Ababa, is right here with us. I have to say frankly, Mr. Ambassador, that I'm profoundly honored and exceedingly humbled to have the opportunity to host you for the first time on Straight Talk Africa.
Thank you, sir, and thank you for having me. You know, I grew up as a kid listening to VOA and BBC, and on VOA I used to enjoy the Jazz Hour by Luis Canova.
Really?
It's a real pleasure and a privilege to be here.
Very interesting.
It's beyond all my wildest imagination. Thank you, sir.
Very interesting. And of course, you have had a very, very distinguished diplomatic career. The last time I checked, you've been to Havana. Does that mean you speak some Spanish?
Un poquito.
You've been to Cotonou, Benin, which means you probably speak French.
I learned French in Cotonou, actually. That was
really?
My first posting. And that remains a special place because I met my wife in Cotonou. I got married in Cotonou. My first child was born in Cotonou with a Benin passport, a Benin carte de naissance. Yeah. So Cotonou, ma apporté beaucoup de bonheur.
Oh, very interesting. Yes. But of course, if it really wasn't for the Scramble for Africa, that meeting in Berlin, 1884-85, and Chancellor Prince Bismarck. Mm-hmm. You probably wouldn't, in fact, have those artificial boundaries separating Ghana, Nigeria, and Benin. Those are your people, you are the same people.
You know, I'm glad you begin with this subject. You know, I used to be secretary to President Mahama.
That is correct.
And we went to Berlin for a visit. It was Africa, Germany, something. And we had an informal lunch with the president, Horst Schola. And he said something which stuck in my mind. He said that there's this Africa Hall 100 meters away where the meeting, the Berlin Conference,
the partition
Africa was held. And he suggested that we ought to go and have a look there because a lot of our history was there. So I began to take an interest in that. So I began to look for the proceedings. And I got a book. I didn't quite get the proceedings, but I got a book which tried to reflect the proceedings. There was a seminar.
Mm-hmm.
Fascinating stuff. And I believe that Africans have got to take an interest, have got to formally seek the full record of those proceedings, because in these proceedings, you begin to find out what went into deciding how Cote d'Ivoire became Cote d'Ivoire, how Ghana Gold Coast became the Gold Coast, how Congo Brazzaville became French and Congo Leopoldville became Belgian, the intrigue and negotiations, the interest that went into dividing up the continent. And then it begins to dawn on us that we were not eternally divided, that our division was man-made, and so man can restore the integrity of the continent again, which really is the raison d'etre of the African Union. All the African Union is seeking to do now is to disentangle the knots to which we were tied in Berlin 1884-85. So it's a very critical year for us, and I wish that African governments and African people could pay a little more interest to that, because it shows you where we come from.
Now talk to us
sincerely. Tells you where we can go to.